Today we're going to make a collagraph print from the back of a rice carton. You can use any paper food carton. Pasta, cereal, crackers, they all work. Use a sharp tool to incise a drawing into the card. An ice pick, a tack, a sewing needle, or an awl will work. You're impressing a groove into the paper that will hold ink. To create some dark areas on this print, I'm going to use carborundum, which is sandpaper grit, mixed with Liquitex gloss medium and varnish. I've used the sharp tool to retrace this drawing to create a groove in the paper around the figure and the sunflower. And with the paintbrush, I'm going to adhere carborundum all around the figure and the flower. All the texture you see around the figure will hold ink, so that even after I wipe the plate, I'll get rich, dark around my lighter subject. You can mix the grit with acrylic medium and paint it around the figure, or sprinkle the grit on top of wet medium. Either way, you'll see in this demo that you don't need a lot of grit to get some nice rich darks. Before you begin printing, be sure to seal the plate with more acrylic medium on the back, the front, and the edges with at least two thin layers. Now we're ready to ink the collagraph plate. We want to make sure to push ink in the lines that we pressed into the paper with our sharp tool. The acrylic medium has two jobs here. It's sealing the plate to keep the ink from soaking into the paper, and it's creating a very slick surface. So smooth areas will clear easily when we're wiping ink off the plate, and the slick surface will also release the ink once the plate comes in contact with printmaking paper. If you don't have carborundum, you can try scratching the surface of the paper, or try substituting cornmeal instead of carborundum with the acrylic medium. I'm going to use Aqua Intaglio ink, this is etching ink, in Payne's Gray. Be sure to stir your ink, and I'll support the collagraph plate on an old phone book while I'm applying the ink. Aqua inks run a little bit loose, so applying them to a thin plate like this should be pretty easy. The tool I'll use to apply the ink is a craft felt ink dauber. These are made by cutting strips of crafting felt, rolling them into a cylinder, and wrapping a piece of masking tape around the belly. I'm using the end of the dauber in a circular motion to push ink into the incised lines around the figure and all around the grit in the background around the figure. The goal here is to make sure that ink is embedded in every little indentation in the paper, as well as around every kernel or grain of grit. So whether you embed carborundum or cornmeal or even sand in your acrylic medium and apply it to the plate, that texture will hold a lot of ink, even after we wipe the plate. This is a great way to control lights and darks and increase contrast in your designing of collagraph plates. After you print your collagraph plate, if in the print you would like to have more contrast, there's nothing stopping you from taking some medium, adding some more carborundum or cornmeal or grit, and applying more layers to the areas that you want to print darker. Don't be afraid to adjust your plate after you've done a proof print. I'm using pages from the phone book rolled into a ball to start to remove ink from the plate. You don't need much more than medium pressure in a circular motion to start seeing the areas that are clear and glossy, where the figure and the sunflower are. The ink removes easily, versus areas around the figure that have texture. So we can see that the grit is already doing its job of holding the darks. I'm using both sides of each foam book page, which will deteriorate over wiping and time, but that's okay. And if you don't have an old phone book to use like this, you can use newspaper or newsprint. It works just as well. If you're using an oil-based printmaking ink that isn't a water wash-up, it'll run quite a bit thicker, and it may deteriorate your newsprint or your phone book pages a lot quicker. I'm going to switch now to tarlatan, which is basically starched cheesecloth. This one isn't very starched. It's made by Aqua, and they refer to it as Aqua wiping fabric, and each piece can be used over and over again. I'm stabilizing the plate by holding a wedge of the phone book over the plate so I don't leave fingerprints in the ink. And with a very light pressure, I'm mostly just buffing the top of the figure and the sunflower to remove any veils left on there of the ink. The goal here is to remove ink from the uppermost surface, but leave ink in the line work around the figure and in all the texture around the sunflower. And as a last step, with a paper towel wrapped around my finger, I'm clearing some of the brightest parts of the composition where I want the paper to really show through without any veil of ink left. And the paper towel works beautifully for this. You can create highlights in your design by strategically wiping some of the areas and leaving others in halftone. This approach to wiping in steps on your collagraph plates so that you're wiping broad areas first and then gradually finer and finer in your details and attention will give you much more effective halftones and values in your collagraph prints. Now, since the paper card that the collagraph plate is made out of is so thin, I've cut a same size piece of mat board to slide underneath it to bring it up a little bit so it's closer to the cylinder on my press and the press doesn't have to work so hard to push the paper into the texture. I'm printing on Arnhem 1618 printmaking paper that has been soaked very briefly and then blotted. I'm printing the collagraph on my Takash tabletop etching press. But this collagraph plate is small enough that it can be printed on small craft machines that are being used as presses, like die cutting machines, stenciling machines, pasta makers, and laundry manglers. Visit the Craft Press Printmakers group on Facebook for a ton of great ideas and tips on how to use alternatives to printing presses. So now I've got my collagraph print with all kinds of fun, sketchy texture in the background. And enough of an outline on the figure and the sunflower to be able to bring those out a little bit more by adding other media like watercolor or colored pencil or pastel or crayons. Since Akua ink dries via absorption, it's dry by the next day, usually for me. I'll clean the plate, put it away, and then pull out colored pencils and begin enhancing the details on the figure and the sunflower. The carborundum added excellent texture to the paper that the colored pencil stuck to beautifully. I hope you'll give this a try. Make a collagraph plate from food boxes in your pantry or use mat board, also known as press board and mount board in other parts of the world, and experiment with adding textures to hold ink on your plate. Let me know if you have any questions. You can leave a comment here or visit my blog at belindadelpesco.com and leave a comment over there. And you're invited to go over and visit Belinda Tips to sign up for a free video mini course with 6 tips to help you paint more often. Thanks for visiting, and I hope you make something soon.